Okay. Sub sine conjugate, curly sine of curly x, and here I think there is no sine involved because this is df over gx minus. Okay. I think there is no involvement of sine, and because that sine will give you this one, so from, okay, there is sine, and from minus infinity means this is the derivative form, so this is from minus infinity to plus infinity. And you know that this integral goes to 0 as x goes to plus minus infinity. So I can write that this is equal to minus ih bar over 2u and minus infinity to plus infinity sine conjugate curly sine over curly x minus curly sine over curly x conjugate sine and dx, and this is equal. Now we can further integrate this thing by parts, because we know this is also a function of xt, this is a function of xt, so they are two. You can further integrate them by parts, but let me first write them in this form, that this is equal to minus ih bar over 2m and integration from minus infinity to plus infinity. I will write the first term, which is psi conjugate curly sine over curly x and dx, and minus integral from minus infinity to plus infinity, and then the second term, which is psi curly sine conjugate over curly t dx. Right? So now I can write for this one, for example, means doing integration by parts, I can write that integral from minus infinity to plus infinity and curly sine conjugate over curly x and sine. It doesn't matter if you write this one first, this one second, or this one first, this one second, because there is no operator there. So I can write dx. Now what this will be? You can write first function into integration of the second function. Now when you write first function, it will be sine. The second function will become sine star, psi conjugate, and then it will get limits from minus infinity to plus infinity, and I know this will go to zero because sine is going to zero if x goes to plus or minus infinity. So the first term will give you zero, minus the second term from minus infinity to plus infinity, and then it is what? It is derivative, means integration of the first function into derivative of the second function. So integration of the first function will give you what? Sine conjugate, and derivative of this one will give you curly sine over curly x, right? So you can write curly sine over curly x and dx, while the other term is equal to zero. You know the reason for this zero. Why this will be zero? Because first function, this is your first function, this is your second function. First function, into integration of the secant function, this will become psi conjugate from minus infinity to plus infinity. And I know that this thing is going to zero because both psi and psi conjugate are going to zero if x goes to infinity. So this one is zero while this one is equal to this. So I can write that for this term, I got that this is equal to just, you can say, the reverse of it. Look here. This one is psi curly psi conjugate by curly, this one is x, not t. Okay? Psi curly psi conjugate by this, and we prove that this is equal to the minus of psi conjugate and curly psi by curly x. So you will put it here, then this thing and this thing are the same, right? But you are having minus here, one minus is here. So this will become plus. So it will become two times. And when it will become two times, then they two will simplify with this. So I can write that minus I h bar over 2m. This one, I write minus infinity to plus infinity psi conjugate and curly psi over curly x dx, and then minus, and for this one I am having minus curly this one, so this will become plus, and integral from minus infinity to plus infinity psi conjugate curly psi over curly x dx. So this thing is equal two times, it will become two times. So minus I h bar over 2m and two times minus infinity to plus infinity psi conjugate and curly psi over curly x and dx. Now 2 will cancel with this, so I can write that this is minus I h bar over n, and from minus infinity to plus infinity psi conjugate curly psi over curly x dx. So this is the value I found for d over dt in x, and from here now put this value back in this equation. Let's say this is your equation 4 and this is your equation 5. So put this value, okay, better this one should be 4 and this one should be 5 because this one is derived later. So put 4 in 5. Okay? Put this value of, this is the value of d over dt of x. So I can write the p, expectation value, m, and for d over dt of x I can write this value minus I h bar and m, and this minus infinity to plus infinity, and then psi conjugate curly psi over curly x dx. M will cancel with m, and then this thing is equal to minus I h bar. If I move this one inside, in order to skip one step, minus I h bar, so I can write this a constant, so minus infinity to plus infinity, and then I can write psi conjugate, and this is just integration by parts. I hope you will do it.
Yes, sir. Is there?
You can utilize this equation back in there. Yes. Okay. So this is just integration by parts. I have simplified this one. Just put this value back there, and you will get it variation. Okay. So sin conjugate, and now I have moved this minus I h bar here, and I can enclose this one. And what is this? This is the momentum operator. It means that actually this one is the expectation value of P, right? Because the operator, this one is the P operator, which is equal to we write P in this form. So it means that it is right to use this relation. Though it's a classical equation, but it is right to use that P is equal to m dx over dt. There is no harm in using this thing. Clear? We will now solve problem 1.17. Now problem 1.17 is in your further problems. The problems that you are having at the end of the chapter. This is problem 1.17 and further problems. It is saying a particle is represented at time t equal to 0 by the wave function. Wave function is given. Now the wave function which is given is at time t equal to 0. So this is sine x 0 and this is equal to a and a square minus x square if x is between a and minus a, while the equality says that endpoints are included. When it is said is minus a less than x less than a, then it means that x is between minus a and plus a. The endpoints are not included. It is in between them. Means minus a and plus a are not included. But when you write the equality symbol here as well, then it means it is in between them, but the endpoints are included. And this wave function is zero elsewhere or otherwise. This wave function is equal to zero. Now the very first question which is asked in your book is determine the normalization constant A. Determine the normalization constant A. You know how to determine the normalization constant in a wave function. Normalization constant is always determined from the normalization condition, which is minus infinity to plus infinity psi conjugate, and then you write psi and dx, and this is equal to 1. You write in short minus infinity to plus infinity and psi mod square dx is equal to 1. You square this wave function. It is a direct square wave function because there is no iota involved. So it will be a square minus x mod square is integration equal to 1. And I hope that you will very easily determine this normalization constant. This is a very simple integral and the normalization constant will come out is 15 over 16a5 square root. So I will not do this one because it is very straightforward.